Among the bright lights of Las Vegas, it's HIMSS 2018 as we introduce you to some of our Commonwealth Alliance members. Scott Adams here with you. Time now to talk to Chief Technology Officer from Life Image, that being Jonik Joshi. And Jonik, what is Life Image's area of expertise and how you envision your guys' contribution to improving nationwide interoperability?
So Life Image has been a global leader in imaging exchange over the last 10 years. And it continues to evolve our customers' experience in the sense that we've gone well above and beyond imaging, and we are now in the business of exchanging any and all medical information at massive scale, catering to addressing the cost, quality, and patient risk.
Now that you guys have been with the Alliance here for several years, what are you looking forward to most maybe here over the next 5 years or so?
When you think about an alliance like Commonwealth, the word interoperability comes into play. But interoperability is only as good as its ability to translate into the right evidence delivered in the right context. And context is all about workflows in medicine today. So a big part of what and where we plan to influence is utilize the network that we already have in place in the US and globally, and do that at scale in a way that it allows all participants of Commonwealth to contribute their evidence on each one of their specialties in a standards way across hundreds and thousands of physicians, influencing over 100 million patients today.
What's something more that you wish people knew about Commonwealth?
So Commonwealth is really well positioned to be the catalyst for the convergence in healthcare across all horizontals, may it be payers, pharma companies, may it be PBMs, and including providers, of course. And the difference between Commonwealth as the alliance versus a lot of previous alliances over the last 20 years is Commonwealth has been able to very successfully simplify the connectivity issue between multiple systems, and it has been able to successfully engage the entire industry to contribute data in a way that prevents duplication of effort across all the vendors on the floor today. So that has not been done before. So it's the scale of unprecedented agreements, alliances, and collaboration that influences patient care across all verticals, not just hospitals.
Interoperability over the course of the next 5 years, 10 years, where's it headed? At least for the medical industry.
Personal vision is I'd like interoperability to be an afterthought, because when you make a phone call today, you don't think if the person's on T-Mobile or AT&T or Verizon. You just make a phone call. And healthcare needs to be there, not just for images, not just for genetic test results. So interoperability is not going to be commoditized. It's going to be more embedded and ingrained as a critical component for everything that's happening on the show floor. Because if there is no interoperability, there is no data exchange. If there is no data exchange, there is no AI. And if there is no AI, our baseline never changes. So I'm hoping that we don't maintain the status quo, that we challenge the status quo, and essentially commoditize the value of interoperability as a point solution and compete with insights and compete with evidence.
Awesome. One of the proud members of Commonwealth Alliance, that being Life Image and Jonik Joshi, I appreciate it so much.
Thank you.
And to learn more about Life Image, we implore you to jump on to commonwealthalliance.org for more information. Thanks again, Jonik.
Thank you.